The third method we are going to do is winnowing. In winnowing, what we do is, you must have seen the ladies in the countryside holding up the baskets containing grains on their heads and they are shaking those baskets. Why is it done? Because by this process, the lighter particles like husk are removed from the grains and the grains fall down in the form of heap, you can see, and with the blowing air, the lighter particles get separated. So winnowing is the process of separating lighter components of the mixture and by the help of wind. So this process is known as winnowing. The next process is sieving. We all have seen in our homes how is the coarse bran separated from the fine flour. Our mother used to do it, right? So this is done with the help of a sieve, you can see, right? A net kind of a structure. So sieving is the separation method which uses a sieve to separate the solid components of varying sizes from the mixture. If you have a mixture that have components of different sizes, you can use a sieve and you will be able to separate the mixture's components depending on their sizes. Now next we have the evaporation and condensation. Now you take a mixture of salt and water. We are going to do evaporation and condensation both with the same example. Here we are going to heat up the mixture of salt and water in a kettle. Now once the evaporation starts, that is the water starts boiling, you would find that the water is getting evaporated from its spout and you are left behind with salt. So you have separated water from the salt, but this process is known as evaporation because here we have converted the liquid, that is water, into water vapor, or you can say the liquid into vapor, and hence this is known as evaporation. Whereas the opposite process, if you do here, the water vapor that is coming out of the stout is in the form of vapor only, and if you place a tray over it which contains ice cubes, you will find that the steam gets condensed into water and that is getting collected into this beaker, and this process is converting the water vapor back into water form. That is, conversion of a vapor back into liquid is known as condensation. So these are the two processes, that is evaporation and condensation. Both processes are opposite of each other.